you can call a comfort expert. They're pretty good to come in and fix our heater.
What was the company name?
Comfort Expert.
Comfort Experts. All right. Very nice. Very good.
You wanted the number too?
No, it's okay.
Okay, fine.
All right.
She can call a Comfort Expert.
Yeah.
And they come and they fix the furnace because I had the service with them. They're very good.
So going back to your window question, one of the things you want to do is you want to see if the crack is soft to the touch or if there's any discoloration in it.
It came out like... it's just cracking the paint and whatever you call it, you know, a little bit. It's not soft, it's hard.
Okay, that's good. So when was the last time you painted that one?
Oh, it's over 20 years.
Okay, so you might be lucky and that's just simply the paint cracking with movements and everything else because... if it's an old type paint, more often than not, it's not acrylic. It's that old latex, and sometimes that will crack. So it could be just a paint cracking.
I see.
Now, what you could do is you could mark it with a pencil and then see if with time the crack gets bigger. If it does, or you see any discoloration, then we have to investigate it a little bit more.
I see.
Okay. The other thing you would want to maybe potentially do is when the weather is nice, you go outside and you look. If you see that the stone ledge outside is cracked, that could be a source why the water is coming in or a source of water coming in. If you look above it and see that you have mortar joints that are cracked or emptying out, then that could also be a sign of why you have that type of crack below the window. But for now, it doesn't look like it's a water infiltration from what you described.
No, it's not watering. You know, it's dry, completely dry.
Yeah, okay. That's good news for you.
Thank you very, very much.
You're welcome. Thank you for the phone call.
I do listen to your program all the time.
Thank you very much. And
I do not like to miss it. Thank you very much, and have a wonderful day, and happy holiday.
You too.
Thank you.
She's saying all the right things.
That's right.
Tony, are you still there? Tony, come to the phone. How are you?
Hi.
How are you? You wanted to make a comment about a furnace issue that we addressed earlier?
Yeah, exactly. That lady that called earlier with the electric furnace problem. Mm-hmm. I had a problem similar to that several months ago with the furnace, which is click on, click off. It's a very common problem with this particular brand of furnace. I don't know if I can mention it on the air or not. My suggestion to her is do not call any old electrician because these guys will not be able to troubleshoot the problem. It turns out it's a problem with the electronic control card on this particular furnace. So I would strongly suggest she call the manufacturer, and they have a reference of an electrician that does that replacement work here in Montreal. I tried a couple of electricians. They came over. They sort of thought it was a problem with the breaker or the relay. I ended up switching out relays. It didn't work. Finally, I managed to contact the manufacturer, and they referenced me to an electrician here in Montreal that services these particular electric furnaces. So I can give the name off air if you want or whatever.
Very good. Yeah, we'll put you on hold, and then Jimmy will take the information down. He's nodding. All right. Well, that's appreciated, Tony. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Let me put him on hold. Jimmy, you can take care of him. Next up is Peter in Pointe-Cascade. Peter, you're talking about a sewage issue?
Yeah, well, not a sewage issue. Good morning, by the way.
Morning.
Every house, when you look at the roof, you have a pipe. It's like an exhaust, a PVC pipe that comes out through the roof. I think that's for your sewage or your...
No, that's a plumbing vent.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. I have in my upstairs bedroom, in my closet, I have a 4-inch pipe that goes up through the ceiling.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very low roof. Like, there is no attic. It's a very small... It's like a mobile home.
Yeah.
But there is no pipe coming through the roof. The pipe goes through my closet into the ceiling, into the small ceiling, but nothing comes out through the roof. No pipe. And I look at every other house, and they have some sort of an exhaust pipe coming out through the roof.
Mm-hmm.
So why does mine not come out through the roof?
Two reasons. Number one, you had either a very bad roofer that changed your roof last time.
Okay.
Or you had
bought the house.
Okay. Or you or whoever the previous owners, or they had a bad plumber that did not bring the plumbing vent far enough in the roof. Now, typically, when this happens, you have the plumber that brings the stack, the plumbing vent, all the way to the roof area, and then the roofer have to kind of cap it from the top.
Right.
So, if one of these two subtrades have failed in the process, you would have a pipe that disappeared in an attic. And that's not really good, because you don't want to have that type of smells going
in your attic.
And you want to have an unimpeded type of a suction from that pipe. So that pipe have to be up there, free, can suck all the air at once, so the plumbing can work adequately.
Okay.
Now, who to call? Very simple. In my opinion, you should call a roofer. Before you call a roofer, what I think you should do is you go in the attic and you see if the pipe is actually there.
Yeah, you can't get into the attic because it's like a mobile home. It might only be like 10 inches.
Okay.
It's so not very high.
Even a bigger reason why you should call a roofer. So what they do is in that particular area, they'll open up the roof and they will peek inside, get the stack out, and then they will repatch the roof in that particular area.
Now, on the roof, you have your vents, your circulating vents,
yeah.
I guess they're called. I have like three of them. Could they have piped that pipe into one of those vents?
No, not even close to.
Okay, so it's a roofer I call then.
You call a roofer, that is correct.
Good. I appreciate your time,
Peter,
and you guys have a great day.
Thank you. You too, Peter.
Okay.
Thanks for the call. Walter, thank you.
My pleasure. Apologies for everybody that was waiting, and we could not help them today.
There's always next week. He'll be back next Saturday morning at 9 on the Home Improvement Show. Jimmy, thank you so much. You're sticking around because Lisa's ready to go to answer more calls and questions on the Car Show. We'll talk to you again tomorrow morning on Weekends with Ken.
The Home Improvement Show, brought to you by Electrica, Montreal's trusted team of home electrical experts. Electrica with a K.ca.
I'm Andres Pedrix with Royal LePage Elite. If you're thinking of selling your house or of upgrading, downsizing, or buying a new home, call me. Selling or buying, you can absolutely count on me to get it right. Please jot down my number, 892-6547. And remember my name, Andres Pedrix, Royal LePage Elite, 892-6547.
For all your real estate needs, reach Andres, Nicholas, or Alexander, the Pedrix team at Pedrix, PEDRIKS.ca.
Have you been told that hand surgery is complicated? The truth is that most procedures to cure hand pain are simple, quick, relatively pain-free, and our patients typically return to their activities within a week. Hi, I'm Dr. Daniel Durand, board-certified hand surgeon at MontrealHandSurgery.com. If you suffer with carpal tunnel syndrome, de Kervain's disease, trigger finger, or any other condition that limits the use of your hands, our patented micro-incision techniques will get your hands back into shape quickly and better than before. Let me give you a helping hand at MontrealHandSurgery.com.
Good morning. It's 10 o'clock. I'm Tom Whalen with your CTV News Update. Raining and plus 2 downtown. Full forecast coming up in minutes. Here's what's making news right now. Death last night in Rosemont. A deadly storm sweeping through the U.S. South and Midwest, and Pope Francis is released from hospital. With the latest from the CJAD 800 Traffic Center, here's Jill Fitzgerald.
13 southbound is open between the Tecan and Corval and working well. No issues on the West Island, on the Tecan, or on Highway. Are doing okay. That westbound reduced speed between the Laurentian Autoroute and the DeCary Interchange. 138 east access to the 20 westbound, that is closed until Monday at 5 a.m. Detour via 20 eastbound, double back at Angrignon. 25 southbound, heavy going Hochelaga for the outbound tunnel. Laurentian Autoroute is doing fine. The Easter Farm at Place Versailles is ongoing until April 8th. Don't miss out. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, have your face painted near Globule. Traffic and transit every 15 minutes on CJAD 800. Next report, 10:15.
In the news, Montreal police investigating what they are describing as a suspicious death this morning. According to investigators, the body of a 71-year-old man was found last night in a building on 4th Avenue between Dandenong and Masson in Rosemont-le-Petit-Patrie. The man's death was confirmed at the scene. At the moment, police not speculating on a cause of death, nor are they saying if there were marks of violence on the body. The investigation is ongoing. While none of the identities of the 8 migrants whose bodies were pulled from the St. Lawrence River near Aguasasne this week have been confirmed, this morning's Journal de Montréal is reporting that at least one of those who died had been denied asylum here in Canada. Paper states that one of the individuals had immigrated to Canada from Romania a few years ago and with his wife, and that the couple had two young children who were both born in Canada, therefore Canadian citizens. The article cites information received from the victim's brother, who lives in the United States. That man says when his brother learned that his application for asylum had been denied, he decided to head for the U.S. with his family before they were sent back to Romania. He added that he has not heard from his brother since he and his family left the Toronto area, and that he fears for the worst. Aguasasne Mohawk Police are working with both the U.S. Department of Homeland Security and Immigration Canada to confirm the identities of the 8 who perished earlier this week. A deadly storm system sweeping through parts of the U.S. Midwest and South has killed one person and injured more than two dozen at a concert in Illinois.
The Apollo Theater in ruins. The marquee is hanging off the building, and first responders on the ground are speculating the large debris blocking the middle of the road was actually part of the roof. They got the tornado warning at 7:45 p.m. Central Time, the roof collapsing 10 minutes later. Officials could not confirm if a tornado or just bad weather caused this collapse. The governor here in Illinois says he's closely monitoring the situation. Jacqueline Lee, ABC News, Belvedere, Illinois.
And Pope Francis has been discharged from a hospital in Rome after being treated for a respiratory infection one day before the lead-up to Easter celebrations in the Catholic Church. ABC's Marcus Moore with details.
The world has been waiting for his release from the hospital as he has spent the last several days receiving treatment for bronchitis. Vatican officials said the 86-year-old pontiff showed steady improvement after receiving antibiotics.
Francis is vulnerable to respiratory illnesses because he had a part of a lung removed in the early part of his life. Follow us on Instagram and Twitter at CJAD800. Your Dormez-vous Weather Center forecast. This rain should end by the lunch hour. Then we'll see a mix of sun and cloud this afternoon. Chance of showers and windy, the high 13. Clouds and a chance of showers this evening, then clearing overnight. Still quite windy with gusts up to 60 kilometers an hour, minus 9 for a low. Tomorrow, sunny, windy, and plus 2. Then cloudy and 8 on Monday. Right now, it's raining, plus 2 in downtown Montreal. For all the news during the day, stream us on your smart speaker. Just say play CJAD 800. Your next CTV News update at 10:30.
The opinions expressed in the following program are provided for information purposes only and are not necessarily those of CJAD 800 or Bell Media. The opinions do not constitute professional advice. Please contact your automotive expert directly before making any decisions.
Hey, hey. Now the Car Show on News Talk Radio, CJAD 800.
And a good Saturday morning to you one and all. This is your Saturday morning car show with me, Lisa Christensen, here on Montreal's News Talk Leader, CJD 800 AM. I'm a licensed automotive technician, master certified ASC, fixing up your car. Like we do every week here on the CJD Car Show, so get in line. 514-790-0800, 514-790-0800. Let's talk about your car this morning here on the CJD Car Show. So I thought I'd mention a few things because, you know, the weather is beautiful. I wish, you know, I just want to get it over with. I know that a lot of people were running to put on, you know, winter to summer tires and doing things like that. I was going to, but I changed my mind. And then we got the snow. It's not like it was traumatizing. But in my case, my summer wheels, which I am replacing my tires in the next week, the actual rubber is getting changed this year, they're at 4:30 seconds. Now, to bring that into perspective for you, they were 10:30 seconds when they were new. So they're really 40%. And again, 40%. If you look at your tire, you check very carefully the inside of the tread where the grooves are. You're going to see a little bit of rubber that goes from the front of the tire to the back of the tire. And then maybe about 12 inches later, you're going to see the same thing. These are wear band indicators, and they help you to see how much wear you have on your tire, how much is remaining. Now, you don't really want to get to the point where you are touching the bands, because you're done. And you have to, when you look at a tire, and especially in weather like we have today, you're looking at things, how does water escape from the tread so that you have water displacing and you get adhesion to the road. So those are things you should be keeping in mind. And for the for mine that are at 4:30 seconds, I mean, 4:30 seconds doesn't sound like much on a good day. So rain, wet leaves, stuff that's going to be on the road, it's not a good traction, especially being a hybrid. It's much heavier. I don't find that's a satisfactory. And you know, I think it's 2:30 seconds are considered discard by the Société Assurance Automobile de Québec. Last time I checked, 2:30 seconds. You spit in your hydroplaning with 2:30 seconds. That's crazy, right? Why would you even wait that long? But people do. If you want to understand what I'm talking about, just go to a shopping mall and spend time looking at people's wheels as you're walking by. Look at tires. Wait about a month and then you'll see. These are my Baldinis I'm running for the summer. I'm just going to burn them out. But you got to look at the real big picture when it comes to burning out tires. What are you burning out? You're burning out the possibility, especially winter tires. Oh, winter tires in the summer. It's just a greasy adhesion to the road, winter tires. It gets hot. The asphalt gets hot. The cement gets hot. And you have to make a panic stop. And it's just like a greasy grip to the road. You're not really getting good adhesion to the road. It's not good. There's a lot of weight. When you look at your registration of vehicle, look at the mass vehicle weight. Put that into pounds. And then you do the calculation of at 30 kilometers at this much weight, how much room you need to stop. You got to have good tires on your car. You got to. And you have to plan ahead. If a used car you just bought, tires are so-so, start putting $10 a week, put it away. By the time you get to the end of the year, you'll have money to go out and, maybe buy the tires then. Maybe you're at the point where you said they've got a couple of seasons and you keep doing the $10 a week. You get to the second year, you've got enough to get, a good set of tires on your car, and you didn't really feel the pinch. Just think of it as one visit to a popular coffee chain, whipped cream and syrup all over it, and you've already got your tires. So you've got to plan ahead. And I wanted to mention one thing at about car maintenance, because I actually get harassed a lot of times by people saying, it's not broke, don't fix it. Well, it's really simple. The ABCs of cars, basically of your car care. A, always follow your vehicle's service schedule. Very simple. You don't have to be a mechanic for that. B, be sure you have your car inspected when you suspect that there's a problem. If something doesn't feel right to you, the driver, have it inspected. And C, of course, is correct the problem to help avoid the inconvenience or even a potential safety hazard of breaking down when you're away from home. Nothing worse than you got to get to point A to point B and you have a breakdown. Even though you're in the city, it's really inconvenient. So just ABCs, car care. It's very, very simple. And, these are the simple things that you can do, not as a mechanic. When you look outside, It's not very pleasant. It's a lot of water, a lot of water accumulation. Slow it down, especially if you have put on your summer tires and you're questioning their adhesion to the road. The Prius that I have, it's got a closed tread for low rolling resistance. So water gets in on my 430 seconds. I know the weight of the vehicle is going to help. Again, the weight helps. The traction control helps. But at the end of the day, I want to have good adhesion to the road. So I'll have to wait until I get my summer tires. 72 hours, that's all. 514-790-0800. 514-790-0800. Let's talk about your car this morning here on the CJD Car Show. Another mention this morning was, are you driving an unsafe car? What? Well, you need to know about recalls. Now, you'll hear in the news, oh, there's a recall from this car company and this and that. But what if you're not the original owner? What if you're the second or third owner of a used car? How are you going to know if there's a recall if you didn't hear it on CJAD? Well, you should know that you can go on the Transport Canada website for the safety recalls. And they call them, it's on the Government of Canada's website. It's a Motor Vehicle Safety Recalls Database. And you can just go and check under Motor Vehicle Safety, the vehicle recalls and defects, and then you can enter your vehicle year, model, brand, and see if there is any recall. So I did the test with the Prius, and the Prius came up with two recalls. One that won't apply because I don't have a block heater. And the other one was for the safety for the powertrain, for the updating of the software for the motor generator and the hybrid control unit. And it says that the previous updates are not applicable. So interesting to know. So if you're not the original owner, who would be getting the letter from the manufacturer? Whenever you buy your used car, you want to say that you go on the website for the manufacturer and you register your vehicle as the new owner of the vehicle. So that way, if there's any safety or recalls out, then you will get the recall letter in the mail. Small little things that can make a big impact. So you need to know about, you know, what is a vehicle recall? A recall, you know, a safety recall. It's bringing an unsafe vehicle to a dealership to resolve a safety issue. When the manufacturer or the, you know, Transport Canada determines that a vehicle or a piece of the equipment on the vehicle has a safety-related defect. Everybody remembers the airbags, right? Same idea. You can check for your vehicle recalls on the Transport Canada website. And you know what? You have nothing to do. Just take your little phone and doodle away and see if your car or any of your cars may have a recall. And then you can go to the deeper research to see if your specific vehicle at home falls under that recall. And it's really easy and user-friendly to use that on the web. 514-790-0800. Let's talk about your car this morning here on the CJD Car Show. The lines are open and they're filling up quick, so don't wait. Don't procrastinate. Get in line right now to talk about your vehicle. 514-790-0800. But first, it's 10:15 CJD time, and it's time to head over to the CJD 800 Traffic Center and speak to Jill Fitzgerald. Good morning, Jill.
Good morning, Lisa. We have one weekend-long closure of note. That is the access 220 westbound from the 138 eastbound as you make your way off the Mercier Bridge, closed until Monday at 5 o'clock. Detour via 20 eastbound and the Angrignon exit, double back there. 13 southbound had been closed between the Tecan and Corval. It has been reopened. On the West Island, everything is in good shape. We are seeing volume down from Hochelaga, 25 southbound for the outbound tunnel. Laurentian Autoroute is looking good. Champlain Bridge and the 10, problem-free. Visit Farmer Pre now until Friday, April 7th for the spring super sale and enjoy big savings throughout the store. Save big, leave happy. Let us know what you see on the roads. Call in your tips to Star 800. Next report, 10:30.
Can CF Montreal build on their thrilling stoppage time win against Philadelphia?
At the back post, there's Chouinard! Off the crossbar, it's in!
Find out tonight when they take the pitch in Vancouver against the Whitecaps. The pregame starts at 10 on News Talk Radio, CJAD 800, or CJAD800.com.
in a complicated world.
Provincially, federally, globally.
Tom Mulcair is your voice of reason. Twice a day on CJAD 800.
Brought to you by Guaranteed Industries. Beat the summer heat with an energy-efficient air conditioning system installed by Guaranteed Industries. Call 514-342-3400 or visit GuaranteedIndustries.com.
Tom Mulcair.
735 with Andrew and 505 with Aaron and Natasha.
On News Talk Radio.
CJAD 800.
Before you buy or sell a home, listen to The Real Estate Show for the best real estate advice in town. With mortgage and real estate leader Terry Kalakos of Northeast Real Estate and Mortgage Agency. The Real Estate Show, tomorrow afternoon at 1 on CJAD 800.
Air Transat presents a 32-year-old man discovering the basic principles of snorkeling while on vacation in Mexico.
You guys, there's a turtle under me, I think.
Open up a world of experiences with the Hello Spring promo. Book your vacation package down south and get up to 40% off. Visit transat.com or contact your Club Voyage professional. Conditions apply. Air Transat. Travel moves us.
Scene Plus is now at IGA.
Scene Plus, you mean like at the movies?
Now it's also for groceries.
Oh, wow. Am I going to see any superstars?
You'll see a bunch of star products that will earn you Scene Plus points. It's worth it, too. 1,000 points is $10 of free groceries at IGA.
What a plot twist.
And wait till you hear what happens next. This week at IGA, earn 1,000 bonus points when you spend $100 or more using the coupon in the flyer. Scene Plus, now at IGA.
At Automobile on Direct, we have over 2,500 vehicles in inventory at the best prices on the market. With all makes and models, we have the largest inventory in Quebec to guarantee you the best prices. Make an appointment at automobileondirect.com today.
Suffer from back pain? The Back Doctor Show on CJAD 800 just might have your relief.
I'm Dr. Morissette, chiropractor, and will take your calls and answer all your questions. Visit chiropratic.com for more information. You can find tips and advice for daily activities and the chiropractor closest to you.
Join Doc Morissette, chiropractor, for the Back Doctor Show this afternoon at 1 on News Talk Radio, CJAD 800.
What can you expect to find during Corbeil's Easter promotions? Just the most exceptional fridges, stoves, washers, dryers, dishwashers, and more at excellent prices. We're talking savings of up to $1,500 per appliance and many other exciting surprises in store. This is one Easter promotion you can't afford to ignore. Hurry! Ends Wednesday, April 12th. Corbeil, for the right reasons. Details at CorbeilElectro.com. Exactly.
Centaur Theatre proudly presents the English language premiere of the Théâtre du Cep production of King Dave by Alexandre Goyette. After touring Quebec with a tremendously successful run at Théâtre du Cep, Patrick Emmanuel Abelard returns to the Centaur stage with the... Quebec Theatre at Centaur Theatre until April 16th. Get your tickets today at CentaurTheatre.com.
Want to take your motorcycle, convertible, or RV out of storage? Make your life easier. Get it done faster with Saclic, our new online services platform. A message from the Société de l'Assurance Automobile du Québec.
On the next Lotto 649 draw, you could win $56 million. That's so big, you'll have money to roll around in. But we don't want you to roll around in it, not literally. Anyway, you know what we mean.
This is The Car Show on CJAD 800.
CJD time. Time to talk about your car this morning here on the CJD Car Show. So get in line at 514-790-0800. 514-790-0800. Let's go to the phone lines now and speak to our first car. We got Giselle. Hi, Giselle.
Hi. Yes, good morning.
Go ahead. Tell me about your 2013 Kia Forte.
XE, yeah. I have only 57,000 kilometers on it. And now it's two times that it happens to me that I can't let's say I'm getting home and I want to put it on park.
Yes.
It doesn't go on park. It blocks right there. I can go on any gear
yep.
but park.
Do you have, where your shifter is, do you have a little cubby right in front of it with the stuff that you can put things in?
Yes.
Have you made sure that there's nothing interfering with the shifter? Because I'm going to tell you, my dad did the exact thing. And he's got a bunch of beads that my daughter had made him when she was smaller, little bracelets, and they were interfering with him putting it into the final lock. So I just want to make sure that there's nothing obstructing around the shifter. Let's just make sure that when you go to put it up atop, it won't touch anything at the end of the travel. So if you've got anything in there that might have got in between, just make sure there's nothing there. That's the most easy thing we can check. Then after that, well, then obviously it comes down to the question of, could it be that on your Kia Forte, there's, because you don't drive it a lot, that there could be rust or corrosion that's built up on the transmission itself. A lot of the cars on the road, not all of them, but a lot of them, I don't see every single one, have a shaft that's external to the transmission where a cable will then connect to it. And that's the cable that when you use your shifter, it moves a little lever on the transmission back and forth. The lever goes through what we call a park neutral safety switch inside the transmission. Other models have the cable exactly like we're talking about, except it goes right inside the transmission and the end is working on a lever inside the transmission. It's no more outside. Yours, I believe, is still external, in which case water corrosion over the years can get in there and just make it a little bit stiff so that you can't get it always into the, depending on the temperature, you might be able to. Some days you will, some days you won't. So that would have to be checked. And the easiest way to check a car like yours with an external cable is quite simply, the mechanic goes in. I think it's got to take off the air bowl and everything to get around to it, to get down to that spot. You mark the position of the bolt. It's always easier. The mechanic. Mm-hmm. Unscrews the bolt, lifts off the cable, goes back into the car, uses the shifter. If the shifter now is working perfectly smooth and all, there's no binding or grabbing, the cable's not an issue. Put it back on. Mark them in the right place and then try it again. It's most likely the shaft, and that can usually be again, we try to clean the shaft first without having to make a big expensive repair.
Okay.
So by just the mechanic going in, determining what kind of cable you have, you making sure that there's nothing interfering, take everything away from it and have a good look at it and just put it back all the way in park, put it down to the bottom, put it back in park, see if it feels tighter as it's getting closer to the top, and then have the mechanic check the cable and see if there's a good good movement there, and see if it can, if it's not, and see if it can be cleaned and lubricated to check if we can get away with not having to go inside the transmission.
Okay, because I made an appointment for Tuesday.
Okay.
But like I said, it only happened twice, and every time I went to see him,
he didn't happen.
Played with it, yeah. And he got it finally, you know, on dark.
So now you can do your little bit by making sure there's nothing obstructing. He can do his bit by saying, look, the problem's not there right now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to check the cable itself. I'm going to move the cable back and forth, and we'll see if the cable's got any kind of stiffness or friction into it. Mm-hmm. And ask him to, if it's the external kind, to go ahead and maybe clean and lubricate it right now, even though it may not be happening right now, and then you just check the car again. If I can do, if the problem is still existing, then we're going to have the transmission.
Okay, so that's good then. That's what I'll get done.
Perfect then.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. You have yourself a great day. Excellent. Good stuff.
You have a nice weekend.
You too. Bye-bye. 514-790-0800, 514-790-0800. Let's go speak to Joanne about her 2011 Nissan Altima. Cleaning the motor, are we?
Yes, good morning. How are you?
I'm very good. Go ahead. Spring cleaning has begun.
Yes, exactly. So I just wanted to have your opinion on getting the motors clean, and because where we get our cars washed,
yeah.
They do that, but I said to my husband, I said, I don't know if we should go to them or if there is, I know, places that are specialized in cleaning motors. And what's your opinion on getting it done?
Sure. So I'm assuming you have a clear engine compartment, meaning the hood is clear plastics and everybody can see your engine?
Yes, yes.
Your hood that you close when you check your oil, or your hood you close when you check your windshield washer fluid, the hood of the car is in clear plastic?
Oh.
No. I'm just...
I don't know.
No, it's not. I'm making a sarcastic joke.
I don't know.
And the reason I'm saying that is because you can't see the engine unless you open the hood.
Right.
You can't. So
right, exactly.
Detailing the engine is because it's like there's a personal choice, and you got to be very careful because how is it cleaned? Is it cleaned using high pressure washer? Is it cleaned using a garden hose? Is it cleaned with chemicals that are not friendly to the environment that go down the drain?
Right.
It's all relative there, because I've done many cars that came in with electrical problems years later. And it's because the soap that was used for the engine wash was inside the harness, and it was conductive. So it was causing these low voltage systems to act up because it was creating a conduit between the terminals.
I see.
So
yeah.
I'm not a fan of cleaning an engine, and I wouldn't buy a car used if the engine was detailed up to, because I don't know if it's got an oil leak that they're hiding or antifreeze leak that they're hiding. You know what I mean? So I'm not the biggest fan when it comes to that.
What about us doing it, which is the garden hose? There's no...
No, why do you want to wash your engine?
Because it's so dirty.
Yeah, but you don't open the hood to look at it all day, do you?
No.
And what is dirty about it? Is there oil leaking?
Oh, no, not at all.
It's just dust.
Yeah, yeah.
So make yourself happy. Here's what you can do. Open the hood, get yourself a can of WD-40, spray a nice cloth with it, and just go around the engine compartment and give a little rub here, and that's a little sign of the engine and that. And that'll make you feel better because you're not putting a chemical in, and it'll shine up really pretty, and you won't have to worry about it getting to be a problem. And you know what? You have fun yourself, and make sure the car is cold if you do that.
Thank you so much.
Okay, bye-bye.
Have a good weekend. Bye-bye.
You know, what can you do? Some people want to keep their engine clean. Oh, 514-790-0800. We go to our next caller of Donna. Hi, Donna.
Hi, I've just got a question. With all the cars being stolen lately, is it a good idea to have an engine kill switch, or would they get around that also?
You know what? The way, because I'm in another line of work during the 5 days of the week, and we meet with the police chief in our neighborhood a lot, and they want it, they're taking it.
Yeah,
that's the way it is. There are things you can ask your insurance company, especially those Mazdas. Holy jeepers, those Mazdas are like, you get one of those, you better have a chain to your house. Because it's like, I know people personally that have had them stolen. I mean, I have two people that I know have had their Mazda, the little sport utility, stolen. We've seen them stolen and then placed in another part of town for a couple of days, and people report it because they want to see if there is a tracking system on it, which could be beneficial for you. A kill switch, speak to your insurance company. Do they recommend a kill switch or a tag system? Every little thing you do just makes it that much harder for someone to want to steal your car, where they'll move along to the next one. You put up engine kill switch installed, a tag system installed, a Sherlock installed. Leave that in your window and just go say, oh, it's not worth it. Move to someone else. Good luck, Donna. Thank you so much for the call. It's 10:30 CJAD time, and it's time to head over for a CTV News update with Tom Whalen.
This newscast brought to you by ElectroAid, heating and air conditioning specialists for over 70 years. They service all brands, no matter who put them in. 514-333-7460, ElectroAid.ca.
Good morning. It's 10:30. I'm Tom Whalen with your CTV News update. Here's what's making news right now. Montreal police have set up a command post on 4th Avenue in Rosemont-le-Petit-Patrie this morning following what they are describing as a suspicious death. Investigators say there is not enough information at the moment about the death of a 71-year-old man to determine if the matter is criminal in nature. The NDP Association issued a press release today stating that NDP leader Jagmeet Singh Singh and Rosemont MP Alexandre Boulris will be speaking at a venue on Monkland Avenue this afternoon. The two will be discussing this week's federal budget. And investigators looking into the discovery of eight bodies along the St. Lawrence River near Aguasasne have not yet made any direct connection to a missing 30-year-old from that community. Casey Oakes was last seen Wednesday night operating a boat that was found Thursday next to the eight bodies. With the latest now from the CJAD 800 Traffic Center, here's Jill Fitzgerald.
Busy drive on DeCary northbound, Côte Saint-Luke to Côte Saint-Catherine. Once you get beyond the entrance just north of Queen Mary, things ease up and no volume up at the top near the DeCary interchange. Met westbound does have volume between the 215s. Drive on the West Island is looking good. Your 138 east access 220 westbound, Montreal side of the Mercier Bridge closed until Monday at 5 a.m. Detour on 220 eastbound, double back at Angrignon. Volume ahead of Hochelaga outbound tunnel. Other South Shore spans are doing okay, and there are no issues on the Laurentian autoroute. CIBC Smart Everyday Banking has money insights that help you easily track your spending. Switch and you could get up to $400. Visit CIBC.com/smart. Let us know what you see on the roads. Call on your tips to Star 800. Next report, 1045.
Your Dormez-vous Weather Center forecast. This rain should be stopping by the lunch hour. Then we'll see a mix of sun and cloud this afternoon with a chance of showers and windy, the high 13. Clouds and a chance of showers this evening, then clearing overnight. Still quite windy, gusts up to 60 kilometers an hour, minus 9 for a low. Tomorrow, sunny, windy and plus 2, then cloudy and 8 on Monday. Right now, raining, still plus 2 in downtown Montreal. Your next CTV News update at 11 o'clock.
The MUHC Foundation and CJAD 800 present Health Matters with Tara Schwartz, featuring the health experts who are making life-saving discoveries and championing patient care.
This week on Health Matters, deciding to donate your organs is so much more than signing the back of your health card. An expert shares what you should know.
Health Matters, tomorrow at noon on CJAD 800.
That's annoying.
What?
You're a muffler. You don't hear it?
I don't even notice it. I usually drown it out with the radio. How's this?
Oh, yeah. Way better.
Save on insurance by switching to Bel Air Direct and use the money to fix your car. Bel Air Direct. Insurance simplified. Conditions apply.
Rib and Reef has been Montreal's premier steakhouse for over 60 years. They've built up a reputation as one of the classiest places in town. For those who appreciate traditional service, USDA dry-aged beef, fresh fish and seafood, and an award-winning wine selection. Add to that valet parking, and you know that at Rib and Reef, you'll be taken care of. All you have to do is enjoy. Rib and Reef Steakhouse and Cigar Lounge, DeCary near De La Savanne, 514-735-1601, or ribandreef.com.
Why should I have a funeral?
This is Bridget Federley from Canaan Federley Funeral Home. As family and friends reunite during a funeral, mourning becomes a shared experience. We cry, we support each other, and we share warm memories. At Canaan Federley, we work hand-in-hand with our families to honor the life of their loved one.
Canaan Federley, recipient of the Consumer Choice Award from 2021 to 2023. For information, call 514-481-5301 or visit canefederley.com.
In today's news, anti-Semitic propaganda continues to spread. Anti-Jewish sentiment can be found everywhere, from academic articles to children's books. Political cartoons depict the Jewish people with grotesque, exaggerated features. Jews have also been accused of deliberately spreading deadly disease. And now, a local man has been found guilty of promoting hatred against Jews by writing hundreds of articles for a neo-Nazi website.
Anti-Semitism isn't history. Visit the Montreal Holocaust Museum and help fight hate.
This is a tradition unlike any other, where green is more valuable than gold. The Masters, April 6th to 9th on TSN and CTV, presented by Mercedes EQ.
When big stories break.
Police got the call Monday night at 7:15 that multiple shots were fired.
Turn to the team you trust.
Matt Grillo, Quebec City.
For breaking news wherever and whenever it happens, watch CTV News at 6 and visit ctvnewsmontreal.ca.
Baby, you a song man.
This is The Car Show on CJAD 800.
What up, Mary? All right. I got my windows down. In the radio. Get your radio.
10:36 CJD time. Hopefully you're not driving with your window down. What's a mess out there. And it's going to be messy for the next several days of driving. Make sure your wipers are working properly. Make sure you turn on your gosh darn it headlights when driving. Get rid of that daytime running light stuff where your dash light is lit up. I don't know. That should be outlawed. But then again, that's my usual pet peeve, right, folks? If you've been listening to this show for almost 30 years, like I've been doing it, headlights have always been a pet peeve of mine. Well, we're going to go back to the phone lines because I have a couple lines open just for you at 514-790-0800. 514-790-0800. Maybe you're looking at getting your tires put on. We're going to bring on Talon Tire. Don't worry. We're going to bring on Talon Tire, talk about tire technology, low rolling resistant tires, summer tires, all season tires, tires. Coming up. Don't worry. He'll be on. But let's talk about your vehicle. Let's go and talk at 514-790-0800. 514-790-0800. Let's go back to those phone lines now and speak with Lou. Hi, Lou.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm good, sir. Do you have a four-cylinder or six?
It's a four-cylinder.
And it's a 2007 Toyota RAV4.
Correct. Now, I spoke to you in December, and I'd mentioned to you at that time that I had a problem with the heating where I could not get any type of air coming out of the defrost and at the top of the